Hello students, Apna Study presents you the Hindu news bulletins for the 11th of July. Before we start, don't forget to like, share and subscribe.
National news. COVID-19 management, the Union government.
Delhi High Court asked all states and union territories, UTs, to ensure strict compliance with national directives for COVID-19 management and take necessary measures under the Disaster Management Act. The statement was made in a status report filed by the Union Government through its Standing Counsel, Anil Soni, in connection with the High Court's SUO Motu proceedings.
DDIPO, an epic car crash in China.
Ride-hailing app Didi raised $4.4 billion in its IPO on June 30, valued at $73 billion. Within a week, Didi would have lost more than one-fifth of its market value. Chinese authorities are investigating the company over its use of data, citing privacy and national security concerns.
Sri Lanka's Rajapaksa family.
Sri Lanka's first family has fastened its clasp on power. The cabinet has five Rajapaksas: President Gotabaya, Prime Minister Mahinda, Defence Minister Chimal and Sports Minister Namal Rajapaksas. Together, they control a substantial chunk of the budget and policy.
Cooperatives and all cooperative institutions more empowered.
Union Minister Amit Shah met some leading figures of the country's cooperative sector on Saturday. Meeting came 3 days after Prime Minister Narendra Modi reallocated the portfolios of his ministers. Mr. Shah was given charge of the newly created Ministry of Cooperation. He promised that the Union government was committed to strengthening the cooperative movement.
Chirag Paswan congratulates Pashupati Kumar Paras on joining the Union Cabinet.
LJP leader Chirag Paswan congratulates estranged uncle Pashupati Kumar Paras on joining Union Cabinet. Delhi High Court rejects his petition challenging Paras' election as party leader in Lok Sabha. Paswan hints at disillusionment with BJP, which has kept silent over crisis in LJP.
The holy relics of Saint Queen Keti went to Georgia.
External Affairs Minister S. Jaishankar attended the formal handing over ceremony of the holy relics of 17th century Queen Street Ketevan to Georgia. The relics were found in 2005 at the St. Augustine Convent in Old Goa on the basis of medieval Portuguese records.
Uttar Pradesh Population, Control, Stabilization and Welfare Bill, 2021.
Uttar Pradesh State Law Commission has prepared a draft bill for population control. Under the law, a two-child norm will be implemented and promoted. A person with more than two children will be debarred from several benefits such as government-sponsored welfare schemes. Chief Minister Yogi Adityanath will on July 11 launch the Uttar Pradesh Population Policy 2021-2030.
International news. Afghan authorities prepare to retake a border crossing seen by the Taliban.
Taliban says it now holds 85% of the country, a Taliban official said on Friday. The government has dismissed the Taliban's gains as having little strategic value. The seizure of multiple border crossing and the taxes they generate will likely fill the group coffers with new revenue. The Air Force was under severe strain even before the Taliban's lightning offensive overwhelmed the government's northern and western positions.
Charlottesville takes down Confederate statues.
The statues of Generals Robert E. Lee and Thomas Stonewall Jackson are among hundreds of Confederate monuments in the U.S. They are now widely considered symbols of racism, even if their supporters argue they are a historical legacy. Tensions over the fate of the Lee statue led to violence in August 2017, when a white nationalist drove his car into a crowd of demonstrators.
A large explosion in Mogadishu kills at least 9 people and injures 8 others.
The Al-Shabaab extremist group claims responsibility for the attack. It was the second such large explosion in Mogadishu this month. Police say the police commissioner was the target of the attack, but he is safe. A large explosion targeting a tea shop killed at least 10 people last week.
Haitian President Jovenel Moïse's assassination opens power vacuum.
President Jovenel Moïse was shot dead in his home 2 days ago. The assassination has opened a power vacuum in the crisis-hit Caribbean nation. The US has already said it will send FBI and other agents to Port-au-Prince. The UN has not yet responded to a request for troops to be deployed.
China evacuates 210 nationals from Afghanistan.
China evacuated 210 nationals from Afghanistan as US troops stepped up their withdrawal from the war-torn nation. Among them were 22 people who were later confirmed to be infected with coronavirus. The Chinese Foreign Ministry confirmed that recent returnees included patients. The evacuation flight was hailed as a patriotic victory by Chinese social media users, with related trending hashtags gaining more than 300 million views.
Business news. Services Export Promotion Council, SEPC, preparing roadmap to double services exports.
Services Export Promotion Council, SEPC, is preparing a roadmap to achieve doubling of services exports in the next 5 years. Council has tagged areas such as tourism and hospitality, logistics and medical value travel as champion sectors meriting additional focus. Council urges government to ensure that the new foreign trade policy being formulated includes incentives for services exports.
VA Tech Vabag Q1 of FY22.
VA Tech Vabag Ltd, a pure-play water technology multinational firm, braved the COVID-19 pandemic and posted double-digit growth last fiscal. MD Rajiv Mittal discusses how the firm secured an order book of 9,500 crore rupees. Going forward, we foresee the water market gaining traction, both in India and overseas.
Sports news. Wimbledon final highlights Ashley Barty.
Ashley Barty becomes first Australian woman to win Wimbledon singles trophy since Yvonne Goolagong in 1980. Barty beat Carolina Pliskova 6-3, 6-7, 4, 6-2, 7-6 in the final on Saturday. The Aussie won 22 of 31 points that lasted 9 strokes or more. The victory was Barty's 35th tour win this year.
COVID-19 symptoms, Indian shooters to leave for Tokyo.
The 13 rifle and pistol shooters, training in Zagreb, will leave with the coaches and a physio. The two skeet shooters, Miraj Ahmad Khan and Angad Veer Singh Bajwa, along with coach Mansher Singh, will leave from Rome on the same day. The entire shooting team will meet in Amsterdam to board the flight which will take them to Tokyo on July 17.